पवित्रं चरितं यस्य पवित्रं जीवनं तथा पवित्रता स्वरूपिण्यै तस्यै कुर्मो नमो नमः। यथाग्ने दाहिका शक्ति रामकृष्णे स्थाहिया सर्वविद्या स्वरूपां तां शारदां प्रणमाम्यहम्। My salutations to Sri Sri Thakur, Sri Sri Ma and Swamiji. I also convey my humble pranams to Swami Shivamayananda Ji Maharaj, who has come all the way from Kankurgachi, Swami Girishananda Ji Maharaj, Swami Devarajananda Ji Maharaj, Swami Balbhadrananda Ji Maharaj, Swami Yajnadharananda Ji, and other monastic brothers and brahmacharis. Just now, we heard two beautiful speeches. They were very thoughtful. Both of them spoke eloquently and forcefully within a short time allotted to them. And both of them highlighted various facets of Holy Mother. Yajnadharanji, he told us about the motherhood of Sri Sri Sharada Devi, for which Sri Ramakrishna had left her behind. And Swami Devarajananji Maharaj, he told about this certain traits which mother taught us, that is nirvasana. Santosh is one word which cannot be translated into English. We say contentment, but that is not the right word. Then same-sightedness, that is another trait that we find in Ma Sharada Devi. There are so many qualities in mother, and one such quality that appeals to me is her gentleness. In the Gita, in 10th chapter, that divine qualities, Daivi Gun, Daivi Sampad, have been enumerated by the Lord. In that one trait is Mardavam, that means gentleness, softness, komalta. This is a great quality that we find in Holy Mother Sri Sharada Devi. Even Mahabharata also praises this gentleness when it says mruduna darunam hanti. Daru means fierce, and mrudu is soft, gentle. So gentleness, there is nothing in this world which gentleness cannot conquer. When Holy Mother was returning from Jairambati via Telu Bhelu, she met her dacoit father. See that his fierce heart, how it melted when Holy Mother addressed him, just Baba. Just with one word, his heart melted. His fierce heart, it became very compassionate. Just one word was enough to transform that person. Of course, Holy Mother says, the dacoit and his wife, they saw Mother Kali in me. That is another thing. A drop of water which falls every moment, every day, and it is very soft, but see the great impact that it falls in on the rock. Slowly, slowly you see how it breaks it. Just one drop of water. We take it lightly, but this becomes so soft and it creates a wonderful impact on that rock. Like that, in Bible also we read, Jesus Christ says, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. So it is those who are meek, those who are humble, those who are gentle, they have conquered the whole world. And we enshrine them in our hearts and worship them. They become an object of worship to us. Of course, some powerful people have been there who are very fierce. They may have ruled the earth for some time, but people love to hate them. They don't want to remember them. It is only those who are meek, who are gentle, they alone are remembered. Even the most dangerous or the powerful animals, like dinosaurs, they have been wiped from the face of the earth. Whereas small insects who are in the underground or under a brick or under a rock, see how they multiply. So it is this gentleness which makes us great in the long run. So this is one great lesson that we learn from the life of Ma Sharada Devi. William Shakespeare says, in the 12th night, some are born great, some achieve greatness in their life, and on some greatness is thrust upon. So Holy Mother was born great. She was not a borrowed light. She was the eternal light itself. And this Avrita Chakshu Mother, she was always drowned in her own divinity. She was not a sannyasini. She was not also a householder. She was beyond all these things. People of those times, especially the Orthodox Brahmins, they expected that she'll behave like an Orthodox widow by shaving her head. But she didn't do it. She lived a normal life. 2,500 years ago, Bhagavan Buddha says, Keshaha kib apradyante kleshana mundanam kuru. So what crime this hair has done that you shave them? So by shaving your head, you don't gain in spirituality. You don't achieve anything. So if you have to shave, you shave your kleshas, fivefold ties which bind a human being, avidya, asmita, so rag, desh, abhinivesha. So these are the kleshas we have to get rid of. Then only we become truly spiritual. So it is in this light that Holy Mother showed us new way of life. So without giving much attention to outward things, we have to truly immerse ourselves in the thought of God. Then another quality that appears to me is the purity of Holy Mother. That's why Swami Abhedananda, he composed that wonderful song, Pavitram Charitam Yasya, Pavitram Jivanam Tatha. Such was the captivating life of Holy Mother Shri Sharada Devi. Now, who can sanctify others? A dirty cloth cannot be washed by a dirty water. So you need very clean cloth by which you can clean others. So Holy Mother's life is like that one. So if you have to absolve others of sin, you have to be completely pure, otherwise you cannot help others. She was the embodiment of purity. Even Shri Thakur also, she told that she is purer than Ganga. Once when Shri Sharada Devi was in Jairambati, a close relative of her household, she just returned from outside. It was evening and it was winter also. She complained that she has been made impure by the touch of a dog. she need to take bath immediately. However, mother told her it is not necessary. Just you sprinkle some Ganga water and take a sip of this Ganga water, that is sufficient. But this simple suggestion did not appeal to that lady. She told, how it can help? Then Sharada Devi told, then you touch me. So that also she couldn't understand. That means mother is purer than the Ganga water. Then another thing, even this yogin ma also, who stayed with Holy Mother for a long time, she also sometimes suspected that mother is not spiritually so great, because she always used to engage herself in the service of her brothers, then sisters-in-law, and then nieces and nephews. So she thought she is deeply immersed in worldliness. Whereas Sri Ramakrishna, he was an embodiment of renunciation. He always would go into deeper states of realization. And mother, she is always engaged in worldly things. One day she was just meditating on the bank of the Ganga when she saw in a vision that one newborn baby was floating, and even the placenta was also attached to him. And on the other side, she saw thousands of people are praying to Ganga. Then she had a vision of Sri Ramakrishna telling her, you see, the water of Ganga is not polluted by this dead body. So like that, always remember that Holy Mother is like Ganga, which cannot be polluted by anything. Holy Mother was a wonderful spiritual teacher. She guided people in a very subtle way, some by wish, some by touch. So like that, lot of transformation took place in her devotees. She did not initiate in the way we see nowadays. That's why even one day, one devotee, when he met Sharadananji, he complained, Maharaj, you are taking so much time before giving initiation. Holy Mother, it didn't take her time to initiate others. Sharadananji told, you see, mother is great. It doesn't take her time to know that Thakur has accepted that disciple. So within a few seconds, she can understand. So that's why she gives initiation quickly. But to me, it takes more than half an hour. When I come to know that Thakur wishes him to accept as a disciple, then I initiate him. Mother Sharada Devi, when she was returning from Jairambati via Vishnupur, then she was waiting for the train to come to Calcutta. Though her face was veiled, one porter came unexpectedly from somewhere and he started telling, Mother Janki, you are my Janki, you are my Janki. I have been searching for you. Please save me, give me shelter. So sometimes I wonder, her face was veiled. But you see how this porter could understand that she is Janki herself, she is goddess herself. So unless the grace of mother is there, it is not so easy to understand. So mother told her, just you get a flower and I will initiate you. So then and there itself, mother initiated her. In 1916, when Holy Mother came to this Belumar grounds, Durga Puja was going on. Many devotees came and paid their respects to Holy Mother by touching her feet. Then afterwards, when they left, she found terrible pain in her legs. Then somebody came, Yogin Ma came, and she saw Holy Mother is pouring Ganga water on her legs repeatedly. Then mother told, you see, so many devotees came, they touched my feet, and I have absorbed all their sins. So that's why I'm feeling excruciating pain in my legs. Another time, when she was in Jairambati, one elderly man was coming towards mother. When mother saw, she immediately came to her room and sat on her bed so that the person should not enter inside. But that person, elderly person, he went inside and touched Holy Mother's feet. Mother felt miserable. She had rheumatism. She is telling, it is this rheumatism is there because I accepted the sins of so many people. That is why I am suffering. Oropanandji was there. Then mother tells him, had you been here, you would have not allowed that person to come inside. So in Kolpara also, when mother was there, some devotee came and he was very eager to touch the feet of Holy Mother, but was hesitant whether it would be good to go near mother and touch. But mother encouraged, yes, you come. We are born just for this purpose. You don't worry about this one. Another time when Holy Mother was in Jairambati, Swami Brahmananji Maharaj, he sent 3 devotees to Jairambati with a letter. When that letter was read to Holy Mother, she felt very sad. A son always sends good things for her mother, and you see what sort of people, what sort of stuff Rakal has sent to me. And she was about to tell them, no, you go back to Calcutta, I will not initiate them. Then she prayed to Sri Thakur, and then out of compassion she initiated those 3 people. Later on, when this news came to Swami Brahmananji Maharaj and other senior Swamis, they became very grave. Swami Premananji says, grace, grace, the poison which we cannot digest, we send it to Holy Mother. So this is this Holy Mother's life. She did not reject anyone, whether he was a virtuous person or a wicked person, whether it was an animal or bird or anybody. She gave her infinite love to everybody. In Vedanta, we find 2 aspects are there. One is neti neti and iti iti. On the one side, we find neha nanasti kinchana. So, neha nanasti kinchana. And on the other side, we find sarvam khalvidam brahma. So, everything is God in this world. Swami Vivekananda, while giving lecture in London in 1896, he says, the greatest expression of renunciation is in seeing God everywhere. So this quality we find in Sri Sri Ma Sharada Devi. She saw God in and through everything. So you don't have to reject anything. You don't have to see world as it is. So there is something deeper behind it. That one we have to see. So Swamiji says, you have to deify it. You have to deify the whole world. So then you find God alone is there. In our Upanishads also we read, Isha Vasyam Idam Sarvam Yat Kinchat Jagatyam Jagat. So the whole world has to be covered by that God consciousness. So you don't have to reject anything. So this is one lesson, one teaching that Sri Sri Ma Sharada Devi has kept before us. She was the embodiment of this thing. Even in day-to-day life also we find that she saw God in everybody. Once one cup of milk was being offered as an offering to Sri Ramakrishna. When mother saw one small boy with his mouth dry, she felt compassion for him. She told, no, you offer this milk to this boy. Others protested, Ma, this is meant for the offering of Sri Ramakrishna. No, no, I see Sri Ramakrishna in this boy, you offer to him. On another day, when mother was going to offer some sweets to Sri Ramakrishna, she saw some ant was there. Radhu was about to kill that ant, but mother told, no, I see Sri Ramakrishna's head, Sri Ramakrishna's eyes, Sri Ramakrishna's hands in this ant. So everywhere she saw the same God everywhere. Sarva Bhutantaratma Rupam Rupam Prati Rupo Babhuva. So we only read this in scriptures, but practical demonstration we get in Holy Mother's life. Holy Mother, although she was a divine being, but we see a lot of simplicity in her life. Like one incident that comes to my mind is that she was very scared of ghosts. One day she told her disciple, are you afraid of ghosts? She told, no, we are not afraid, because you are there. What is there to worry about that? But she told, no, I am very afraid. I am very scared of ghosts. Then the disciple said, the goblins and imps that you have created, you are afraid of them. Holy Mother laughed, what to do? So this is the simplicity you find in Holy Mother Sri Sharada Devi. She was also afraid of this allopathic doctors and surgeons, because when she was at Puri, there was abscess in her right foot. The doctor was called, and without warning mother, he lanced that abscess, and after that Holy Mother was very scared of these doctors and surgeons. When Holy Mother was at Udbodhan office, she was suffering from toothache. Swami Sharadananji, he called one dentist, and when mother heard that dentist has come, she quickly went into her room and hid herself. Yogin Ma was there. She told Sharadananji, don't you know mother is scared of these doctors? So why did you call doctor? You should have brought some medicine, that itself would have been sufficient. He told, no, mother is suffering from toothache. Because without calling dentist, it will not work. The whole building was searched, but mother was not to be seen anywhere. Then Swami Sharadananji apologetically, he told the dentist, you see mother, we are not able to find her. You please go, please don't mind. Then afterwards it was found that Holy Mother was lying under cot, and above that one chadar was covered. So like this, she was very scared of these people. In March 1881, Holy Mother's mother and along with Prasanna, they had come to Calcutta and were staying in one apartment in Kansari Pada. So when mother went to the bathroom, she opened the tap and she found hissing sound. She immediately came out and told other ladies, you go and see in the tap, one snake has entered and it is hissing. So all of them laughed. They told mother, this is because of the pressure of air that the sound is coming before water falls, so you don't have to worry. So mother, she was so much unsophisticated that these small things, she was very scared. Another incident that happened was in Jairambati. One Calcutta girl was married to the Banerjee family, and she could wind the watch. That was something very strange to mother. I said, that girl is so intelligent that she knows how to wind. Because Swami Gaurishwarananji says, in those days only just two or three ladies were there in whole village of Jairambati who could barely write their names. So that's why mother, when she heard that this lady is able to wind the watch, she was so much, it was something news, that news to her. Sharada Devi, that Ramakrishna Gata Prana, that when we see certain incidents in her life, we find she always remembered Thakur, always dependent on her. When she, immediately after passing away of Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother went to Varanasi, and from there she went to Ayodhya, and from Ayodhya she was traveling to Vrindavan. In the train, she was wearing, when she was sleeping, then she had a vision of Sri Ramakrishna. Sri Ramakrishna, just from the window, is warning her that you are wearing this amulet, that kavach on your right hand. You see, any thief, he may steal it. You keep it, it is very precious, you keep it very carefully. Immediately, Holy Mother woke up, she opened the amulet and then kept in that trunk. So always she found the presence of Sri Ramakrishna. And when she reached Vrindavan, she met Yoginma there, she embraced her, and then she started weeping, both of them started weeping. And then afterwards, she wanted to live like a Brahmin widow there. When she was about to take off her bracelets and bangles, she had a vision of Sri Ramakrishna. He told her that, just I have moved from one room to another room. Why you are removing all this jewelry? Then she started that whole day, whole night, she will remember Sri Ramakrishna there. One day, she had a vision of Sri Ramakrishna. Thakur told him that I have not initiated yogin, Swami Yogananda, you please initiate him. This was something embarrassing to Holy Mother. She told, maybe it is something this out of imagination of her mind that I am seeing it. So she ignored this vision. But again, after 2 days, she had the same vision. And in the meantime, Swami Yogananda also had a vision of Sri Ramakrishna, telling him to take initiation from Holy Mother. Then when Holy Mother got that vision again, then she called Yogananda through Yoginma and then initiated him. And Yoginma says that I was in the adjacent room. Mother became so much overwhelmed with emotion that she, when she gave this mantra, she gave it very loudly. So much full of emotion she was there. At the end of year, when they were returning from Vrindavan to Haridwar, Swami Yogananda was also with them. He was stricken with high fever. Then he had a vision of one strange Devi informing him that I would have killed you, but your guru, Paramahamsa, Sri Ramakrishna, has forbidden me. He is protecting you. So I am leaving you. Just you offer some sweets to one Devi. She pointed out one Devi to her, wearing white sari with red border. So like this, Sri Ramakrishna was always with them and protecting. Now time is not there. With these few words, I invoke the blessings of Holy Mother and pray to her to shower her grace and blessings on all of us. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Hari Om Tat Sat.